It's one of baseball's most memorable moments. Bernie Carbo blasted a three-run homer in Game 6 of the 1975 World Series, leading to a Red Sox victory. And while the world of baseball applauded Bernie, there was one person who never acknowledged his accomplishments, his father.
I remember in Detroit playing one game where I hit a home run into the upper deck. I mean, I crushed it. And I came out of the ballpark, and my dad's talking about being better than Jimmy Rice and Freddie Lynn and being better than me. And I said, better than Freddie Lynn? Better than Jimmy Rice? Better than me? Dad, you know, and I looked at my dad and I says, Dad, there's one difference between all three of us men and even your own son. I played in the big leagues. I'm playing in the big leagues. And I just hit one in the upper deck. And when are you going to say good works, you know, good son? I'm real proud of you playing in the big leagues and hitting one in the upper deck.
Bernie grew up playing baseball in Detroit. His parents' relationship was consistently on the rocks, largely because of his father's drinking and infidelity.
When my father would come home at night and at the early part of my mom and dad's marriage, where he would go out and drink and come back and he would smell, and I knew my mother knew that he was committing adultery.
Bernie desperately sought the approval of his father, but his dad showed little interest in anything he did.
I was an only son. I was my mother's apple of her eye. She loved me very much. I became my mother's everything because of the choices my dad made. And I think my dad became very resentful because of that, because my mother really catered to me.
Bernie channeled all of his energy into baseball, and in 1970 made it to the big leagues with the Cincinnati Reds. During his rookie season, Carbo hit 21 home runs and had 62 RBIs. He was an instant success, but with all the accolades came the pressure to perform every single game. So Bernie turned to drugs and alcohol to take the pressure off, and it quickly became an addiction.
When you experiment with drugs, the first high that you receive from the drug that you are taking, you try to emulate that same high, and it's impossible. When I'd get up in the morning, I'd smoke a couple joints and then drink a couple beers and eat and then smoke a couple more joints and go to the ballpark, take some Dexedrine, Benadryl, and if the cocaine was available, I would probably do cocaine from morning to night.
In 1974, he was traded to the Boston Red Sox from St. Louis. And still, Bernie's father showed no interest in his son's accomplishments. Bernie was hurt and angry, so to hide his pain, he took more drugs.
I said that I would never have an unhappy day in my life. And that if that meant me smoking and drinking and chasing women and doing cocaine and crystal meth and mescaline, I was going to live my life to the fullest. The only thing that I wanted to do is grin. And the drugs made me grin to a point where it came to a point in my life later that I wanted to die.
Over the next 5 years, Bernie's play on the field began to slide. He moved between five different teams until he ended his big league career in 1980. After baseball, he went into business for himself. Then in 1989, he received news that his mother had committed suicide. 2 months later, his father died.
And I took a lot of responsibility for my mother's suicide because of the drugs and the alcohol and the money that I was taking from them to support me. This is when I really realized at the age of 43, 42 years of age, that I really had a problem because I took all my inheritance in 2 to 3 months. I spent every penny that I inherited, which was $118,000 to $125,000, that I spent in 3 months on cocaine, crystal meth, drugs, and things. And this is where I came to a point in my life that I no longer wanted to live.
Then one night, Bernie decided to take his life. But an anxiety attack sent him to the hospital instead.
I thought I had a heart attack because that was the first time I ever had an anxiety attack. I end up in a hospital, Tampa University Hospital, with 500 beds. I end up with this old man, which when I get in there, I was kind of stressed out and I'm taking a little nap and I wake up and he asked me a question. He said, do you know God and do you know Jesus? And I looked at him and I said, no, I don't.
For the next 2 days, Bernie's hospital roommate talked to him about God.
And he started teaching me the things that I needed to understand by faith, believing with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. God loves you. God created you, Bernie Carbo, to love God And he gave his begotten son, Jesus, to die on the cross. His blood was shed. He was buried. The resurrection is that I can turn away from my sin and run to Jesus. So for the next 2 days, I was like a little boy sitting with my grandpa learning the word, and I just wanted more and more of it.
Bernie Carbo gave his life to Jesus Christ. He's 63 years old now. He's happily married to Tammy, and together they help run the Diamond Club Ministries, which focuses on teaching kids and all who listen about the love of Jesus Christ.
This is where my heart is tell people, no matter what you're going through, whatever's happened in your life, through the Lord God, our Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior, the healing power of Christ, that you can heal.